a little context for that piece. But first, let me introduce myself. My name is Dr. William Sauerland. I'm the director of choral studies. And if you don't know, we are from Purdue, Fort Wayne. I assume you know that as you come to this concert. Maybe you've wandered in from the street. That first piece, you never know. The first piece is about a famine that happened in Sudan. And in order for women to save their children's lives, they took the dry grass. That was the really only thing that they had in their communities, was this dry grass, and they weaved them into baskets and would walk long distances to sell them in other communities in order to buy food, because the earth was so stricken with a drought that nothing was growing, and so there was very little in their communities to nourish their families. This concert is not by happenstance on Earth Day, and it's not by happenstance called From Earth to Sky. It is sort of a bookend from our first concert of this year, which was called From Night to Light. And so this whole program in the first half is sort of about being earthly beings and the sort of experiences that we have on Earth. The second half of the program is the ethereal foray requiem, which ends with the movement in paradisum, which means off into the sky or off into paradise. Just to give you a little context to this concert. The next piece that we'll sing was actually intended for a concert in April of 2020. And I don't need to tell you what happened in spring of 2020. And this piece was commissioned for us. So you are to hear a world premiere by composer Richard Campbell, who is commissioned by our dean, John O'Connell. And the words are from women suffragettes. And originally this was supposed to be in celebration to the ratification of the 19th Amendment, which gave the women the right to vote. But since we had no concerts in 2020 in the spring, we now, after 2-year delay, will finally get to sing for you, These Walls Must Fall.
Oh,
just as we transition, I feel like I have to say something just to fill up the time. But what I would like to tell you is while we heard one world premiere, and that makes for a pretty interesting and awesome concert, tonight we actually get two world premieres. And that is the next piece, which was written by one of our colleagues at Purdue Fort Wayne, one of our professors, Geoffrey Hepker, reached out to colleagues across campus and asked for text that was inspired by the idea of From Earth to Sky. And so these English professors at Purdue Fort Wayne wrote this text, and then he set some of that text to music for us to sing tonight. But I would love for you to hear the complete poem. So we've got three students. Wow, you made it out so quickly. My speaking time worked. So the three of you will read so you can hear the full poem.
Something always escapes, a solitary gaze, through the bend of elms, the widening willows. Another view occurred when I release. There was a crow trying to fly through the darkness of my body, as it should be, as it must.
No one believes me when I say there's a cello in my gut. Memory accretes in broken glances. There had been scars in there like musical notes gone wrong, as if words were the world, as if they were not. If you look at the stars and peel back the moon, there is an aching ring, yet even there,
when we think of endings as if they happened, our arms have nowhere to go. Great birds seem to migrate from my hands. There are no saving words as they wheel and screech a pulse. I have so long begged for the marsupial dark. My gratitude now, much delayed, swallows mud and wonders. Who might look deeply into themselves and see the other side of the world?
So
that one out. I did everything. I practiced it every single night. I don't know how they did it. I swear to you, I don't. I even tried to teach my cat, thinking that if I could teach my cat, then I would learn it. But that's why I had to sing that one. I'm just so amazed by them. They work so hard. Before we sing this last piece, afterwards we'll have a short intermission. If you need to know where the restrooms are, there's out this door and down to the left. It's really just intermission for us to sort of get the other choirs up here for the foray while we're young, so we'll try to keep it quick. This last piece is one that we sang in the fall, and we just loved it so much that we had to bring it back. So this is Wild Embers by Melissa Dunphy. Is in one sense very ethereal and very beautiful. Gabriel Fauré was a French composer who lives sort of at the end of the 19th century into the 20th century. And a requiem, in case you're curious, is a mass for the deceased. So tonight we will sing this in memory of everyone who passed away from COVID-19. A couple notes about a multi-movement work such as this. It is generally performed without any applause in between the movements. So if you just hold your applause to the very end, and you'll know you're at the very end if you'd like to follow along with the translations which are in your program, because we're not gonna sing any words in English for about the next 30 minutes, which is the length of this piece, so you can sort of find yourself in this 30-minute soundscape. Since this will be the last announcement that I make, I want to make sure that I give gratitude where it's due, and first and foremost to the folks of this beautiful church who allowed us to do our concert here. We are not in our normal space because tonight we have the great pleasure of singing Fauré's Requiem with organ, which is played by the amazing Dr. Geoffrey North. We're going to thank him today. Up there because that's where he is and that's where the organ is, and if you want to know a little magic, that camera that's been blinking at you all night is so that he can see me. So in case you're curious how this all goes together, how you can have an organist up there and a choir here, it's thanks to this church and a little technology. I also want to give huge gratitude to two people that I have the great pleasure of working with. Emily Bird, who you saw conduct the Chamber Treble Singers, Jonathan Busarow, who's just there, who co-directs Choral Union, and then while we thanked him at the piano, also Evan Keenan, one of our other rehearsal and staff accompanists. They make being the director of choral studies such a joy and so much easier because they're so good at what they do. Enjoy, and thank you for coming.
Thank you.